G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. I thought we'd start off the year with a composite. Got five different photos here, all from Unsplash or Pixabay, to create this picture of the angel in the city here. So as usual, let's get started. We're going to start on our picture of the city here, and the first thing we're going to add is our grate, our sort of like New York grate. And I've used my circular marquee tool just to make a selection of the grate. So we're going to start off with a command C over to our city and command V. Make sure we're on our move tool here, and we'll just resize this grate, make it fit into the picture here. And I'm going to use my perspective tool here to make that quite flat in the picture here, sort of like nearly like a really flat rectangle picture. And that is looking pretty good, pretty much like that. And I'm going to move it into place, maybe make it a little bit bigger in the middle there. Okay, let's add a mask to that picture. And on our mask, we're going to grab a nice soft brush, or pick our paintbrush over here. Let's pick a nice soft brush. Make sure our color is black here. You can hit D on our keyboard to get our colors back to default. Going to make the flow of the brush 25% and the opacity at 100%. Let's make the picture a little bit bigger with our command plus, holding my shift key down just to move up and make my brush a little bit smaller. And I'm just going to brush around the edges of the grate here where that concrete is, just to get rid of that harsh edge and blend that in a little bit more into the road. So just a matter of just going around and blending that in. I'm doing this fairly quickly, so I know that you guys will take a little bit more time, get it looking really good. Okay, so got that blended into the road there. Let's hit Command 0 on our keyboard. Might just make that a little bit bigger while we've got it here. Maybe about that size. Okay, let's come over here to our Eclipse tool. Let's make our fill transparent. We don't want any fill. Let's make the stroke black and the stroke about 20 points. And let's just draw out a circle here. Come back and make that fill transparent. And on that ellipse layer, let's add a gaussian blur. And let's blur that. Quite blurry, about 21.5 I've got it at the moment. Grab our move tool and let's just move that down quite close and drag those sides in around our grate here, just to add a little bit of depth. That's a little bit, still a little bit too much on the blur, or not enough on the blur. Let's blur that. That's looking a little bit better. So around about 35 on that blur. Next thing we're going to bring over is the picture of our model here. And again, to save time, I've already made a selection all around our model using my selection brush tool. So we can just go Command C, back over to the picture of our city, and Command V. Make sure we're on our move tool. Let's bring our model onto the grate here. That is looking pretty good, right in the middle of the grate here. While we're here, we'll add a new pixel layer. We'll pick black. We've still got our brush, but we're going to bring that up now to 100%. Sort of smallish brush, and just right on the foot here, click once, hold your shift key down all the way over to that other foot and click again. And let's bring that down a little bit just for the shadow there. So that's looking pretty good with that shadow. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is add another pixel layer, and I'm going to change my brush to a mist brush. So I've got these clouds and mist brushes here, which I got from Brushezzy, and I'll leave the link below where you can find these brushes. They're very easy to add to Affinity Photo. So we'll click on that one, and I'm going to pick this one here, 410. I'm going to change my color. I'm going to use my color picker here to pick a nice orange color and activate that color. I'm going to leave my flow and opacity at 100. I'm going to bring the hardness down to 0. I'm going to turn this brush around and just above the grate here, and keep turning that brush. It's like that mist that comes out of the grates in New York. So we'll just make a few more. Just looking good, pretty much like that. And I'm going to add a gaussian blur to that as well. Do want to keep some of the texture, but I'm just going to blur it enough that we've got that texture looking pretty good. Might drop the opacity down to about 75%. And I'm going to grab my move tool, and I'm going to stretch that up a little bit so it looks like that's coming out of the grate. Okay, I'm going to duplicate that layer with the command J. I'm going to move one of them underneath my model here as well. So I've got one on top and one underneath. That's okay at the moment. I may just drop that one down a little bit more, maybe to 50, and that one to 50 as well. Looking a little bit better. We can adjust that a little bit later if we need to. Okay, on our model here, we've got our model. Let's add a curves. Flip that to our model so it only affects our model. And right in the middle here, let's just pull that down a fair way till we get that nice and dark. That looks pretty good. We've got our model blending in a little bit more with that background now as well. So let's add a new pixel layer right on top of the model and drag that down underneath her as well. So we're going to grab our paintbrush again. We've got our orange, but I'm going to bring the flow all the way down to about 15% and drop my opacity to about 50. We need a bit of orange on the ground around here, so I'm going to change my brush again just to a basic soft brush, nice and soft. And I'm going to use this orange color still. Make my brush quite big, and that's not too bad, but might drop the opacity down to about 40. Let's add a little bit of orange across there as well. Just on the ground, if it's too much, just drop the opacity up here. That looks pretty good. Okay, let's add our wings now. So let's come over to our butterfly wings. And also you can see I've made the selection of the wings again already. We don't need this middle bit here, just the two wings. So let's go Command C, back over to the picture of our city, and Command V. Back onto our move tool, and let's resize our wings. We want our wings on top of our model here. Just resize those, and what I'm looking to do is get the wings right in the middle of where the darkest part of her back is, just about here. Change the wings to blend mode screen so they're more see-through, and then on these wings we'll add our adjustment, and we'll come down here to recolor. Again, clip that to the wings just so it affects the wings. And let's make them that orange color blending in with that background. And that looks pretty good about there just on our hue. It's at 29.6 at the moment. But have a play. You might want to change it to make it a little bit different. Okay, so still on our wings here. Click on our wings. We're going to add a mask. Click on our mask. We want our colors back to default. So I'll hit D and we want black. Back to our paintbrush, and I want our flow and opacity fairly low again. Might bring the opacity up to 50. The flow can stay at 15 at the moment. Going to zoom in with my command plus, and just on the back of the wings here, I'm just going to try and blend those in so it looks like they're just blending into her back. A bit of blackness right in there, and then a little bit as it goes out. So just blend those corners in and do the same to the other wing here. Nice and easy, just blend it in so it looks like they're going into her back. And I'm just going to do that on the top here, a bit of blending up here, make it look a little bit softer. And down the wings here as well, just all the way down. That's looking a little bit better. Those areas, let's go Command 0. And I'm just going to run around the edges of the wings all the way around the picture just to soften those up a little bit and blend it in a little bit more. And just on these edges as well. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I'm happy with that. On these, like the mist layer here, I'm going to drag that up a little bit further just so it goes there a little bit further. And I'm going to do the same to the other one. I'm going to drag that up a little bit further as well. Looking pretty good. Okay, we're going to add our sort of star layer now. So I'm going to come over here to our star layer. I've just used my rectangular marquee tool just to make a selection of this area. I picked this picture with the stars because of the orange colors in it. Fits really nicely with the city. So Command C again, over to the picture of our city. Command V, make that a little bit smaller with my Command minus. Bring that in. And let's just stretch it over the whole photo here. Change the blend mode to screen and drop the opacity all the way down to about 25, and also I'm going to bring that down in front of the model. I'm going to make a copy of that, Command J, and bring one down behind the model as well. And the one in front of the model, I might bring that down a little bit more to about 20. Let's have a look at this grate now. I still need to do a little bit of work on that. So on the grate picture here, I'm actually going to add a levels. I clip that to the grate. On that levels adjustment, just going to bring this output white down quite a bit just to blend that in a little bit more and add a little bit of black, a bit more about there. Might even make that grate a tiny bit bigger. That's looking pretty good. Okay, let's hit Command 0. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a LUT, and this is one of my own LUTs that I've created. I call it my Instagram LUT. So let's come down here to Adjustments, come all the way down here to LUTs, and I'm going to make this LUT available to you. It'll be in the description below. You can download that absolutely free. I'll also include an orange and teal LUT as well. If you haven't used LUTs before, I'll leave a link in the description to what a LUT is so you can have a read about what a LUT is, a lookup table. But let's load this LUT. So we'll come up here, load LUT. Got the LUT here on my desktop. It's called my Instagram look. And let's open that. And you can see what the LUT does here. It actually adds like a color grade to the photo. I'm going to drop the opacity down to about 60%. So let's have a look at that. That's the before the LUT. That's after the LUT. It gives it a really nice color. So from here, you can adjust any of these layers that you want if you think there's too much. I'm just going to maybe drag this out a little bit more. And drag this one out a little bit more. And I'm happy with that. So there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial this week on the angel in the city. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.